Hello, hello. Who do we have here? Jeez, it's been a long time.
Hello, hello, darling Ingrid. Hello, children. Hello, Katja. Hello, Heidi.
Hello, Stephen Hunter.
Yes, and his kids.
Oh, do they? They also listen, do they?
Well, maybe. He's waiting for us to record again, so it is our chance to.
It's been a long wait. The last episode we had was just before Christmas 2018, and you were just about to go to Israel, and we said, well, bye-bye, Bianca. When you come back, we'll do another episode. We'll start season two. And, well, our fans have been waiting and waiting and waiting, and, yeah, this is the first opportunity we've had. It's you haven't been in Israel all this time. You haven't been in Israel for the last 7 months. You've actually, you only had, how long did you go for? A week? 10 days?
10 days.
10 days.
And wait. It's like the saying, hello, everybody. I must say hello again to everybody, young and old, from age 0 to age 120 or older. We welcome everybody, everyone.
Even though I have but to say, you know, 0-year-olds, they shouldn't be listening to our show. It's probably not safe for 0-year-olds.
Mummies with their little ones in the belly could listen too.
Yo, that's okay. That's okay.
Yeah, so, yeah. And for me, it's like they say in football, after the game is before the game. For me, it has become like after Israel is before Israel. And I'm going in 13, 12 days. I go back to Israel for a month this time.
And hopefully, so, hopefully we don't wait another year.
No.
After your next trip to Israel.
No, but this really made me forget everything else. I was crazy. I was crazy in love. I am crazy in love with Israel, with his people, with the whole country.
You're a big fan, aren't you?
Totally. It has. I've experienced something. I experienced God's love in for His people in His country more than I ever did in Germany. So, and I got caught up. But there is no apology for letting you all wait, for letting especially Ingrid wait.
I've just been sitting here at my computer for the last 7 months, watching my clock, thinking, all right, where is she? She's a few months late.
No, because she couldn't wait any longer. She made a trip to Germany
to see what was going on. I thought I had
and
to
we
come.
We almost passed each other. Even she was in town.
Yes, I did. I actually just got back. End of May, I made a 1 week trip, or 6 days actually. I spent 6 days in Germany. That's minus the fly time of and train time of about 30 hours each way before and after. So I spent 6 days in Germany, and I got back just the beginning of June, and it was absolutely marvelous. I've got a big family there, a lot of friends, and haven't seen them all in a year and a half. So it was great. It was fantastic.
And everybody was missing you. It was just really a short time to catch up with everybody, wasn't it?
It wasn't enough time, actually. I had to sort of flink a few away, and that's why I couldn't publicly announce anywhere that I was coming to Germany, because I knew that I didn't have that much time to see everyone. So it was really as I was telling you just before, actually, I had such a short time that I got off the plane in Frankfurt. Quickly went to the showers. In fact, I didn't actually go to the showers. I lied to you. I had a shower. I did have a shower, but in the disabled toilet. I wasn't willing to pay I wasn't willing to pay a few euros to use their showers, because when the disabled toilet's for free. So I went into the larger disabled toilets with all my luggage. If anyone saw me, they'd probably think I'm a dickhead. Anyway, I went in there and I locked the door, and I was in there for a good hour, you know. And I just, I'd already brought my little face washes with me and my soap and everything. Just went under the tap and I just washed myself, had a full body wash in the disabled toilets, got undressed, you know, got redressed into something that didn't stink from a 26-hour flight. And after that, I caught a train into Hildesheim. And because I'd actually arranged a few months beforehand that I'd meet up. I got invited to a party that same night that I got into Germany. So I was really looking forward to it. There's no way I was going to miss that. So after After 30 hours of travelling, I quickly went home with my aunt and uncle to their house in Marina Water. I stayed there for a few hours and exchanged the presents, told them I loved them, and then I quickly went back to the train station, went to Hanover, and partied and danced till 4 in the morning. So, and then I crashed. Then I was gone. That was it for me that night. But no, it was an excellent start. But most of my days in Germany this time were like that. You know, I was sleeping about 5 hours a night, or 5 or 6 hours a night, just to make sure that I could fit in everyone, to see as many people as I could in that time frame. So it was really nice. It was really everything quite rushed, but it was really lovely seeing everyone again.
You want to talk about the Katja flight
Oh,
stuff,
not
or you
really,
want to?
but
Okay.
you know,
No, 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 no. Then
I've
don't.
talked to everyone about that's asked so far, and it's actually a subject that still weighs very, very heavily on me. It was because I loved traveling with my children. I absolutely love it, and this trip was actually meant to be for myself and for Katja, who's my youngest daughter, Katja. She'd been looking forward to it for a very long time. She'd been counting down the days for about 4 weeks before the flight. We get to the plane, I was about to say the plane station, but it's actually the airport. We get to the airport on the Friday night, just in time to check in and to take off. And the guy, and this is all very quickly summarised, I'm not going to go into too much detail, but the guy turns around and says, no, you can't fly with us today. I look at him and say, what? Did I just hear right? You can't fly with us today because your daughter's passport isn't valid for 3 months, like it should be. It's only valid for 2 months. Now, this appears to be a law for Australian passport holders, not for German ones. For German ones, you know, you can enter and go at your leisure. So because I'm a German passport holder, I'm a dual citizen. I had no issue at all. I've never had any troubles. I've always been a dual citizen. And this was quite a bit of news to me that you had to have a certain amount of validity as an Australian. And because my daughter unfortunately isn't a dual citizen yet, she's still only Australian. And my world broke together when they said that she couldn't come with us, couldn't come with me, I should say. Her world broke together as well. You can believe me when I say that. And there seemed to be no way around it. The airline couldn't help. They weren't very, you know, helpful at all. They must see this every day, so it was all very blasé. They obviously didn't care too much at all that this had just happened, that they'd stopped my daughter from flying. But they also weren't aware of the time restrictions we had personally, because of Heidi and other commitments we have here. So we couldn't just extend when we renewed her passport at some point, you know, in the next few weeks or whatever. So it was a really hard blow. I had to send her home in a taxi that night. I chose not to go back with her. I didn't want to waste my ticket as well. A good thing we didn't, because we never got a refund for hers from Qatar. So I chose to go on my own. And I have to say that was one of the hardest decisions I've had to ever make in my life. You know, do I go home with my child again from the airport? Or do I just push on ahead and see my family? And on the one side, I felt terrible sending her back home. On the other side, I knew that, you know, a lot of people are waiting for me, you know, waiting for us. But it wouldn't have been fair on all the people that were waiting for, you know, for us to arrive as well, just to blow it off and say, nah, you know, we're not coming anymore. So I didn't want to let all my friends and family down that were waiting for us. So I chose to push ahead. Unfortunately, that didn't come without its emotional consequences. And the first leg of the flight, which was 14 hours long from Melbourne to Doha, I cried pretty much throughout the whole flight. much to the dismay of the poor people having to sit next to me. So I
they weren't
think,
that poor.
Oh,
they were emotionally poor, I would say.
Well, the one lady was emotionally poor. I still feel bad for her having to sit next to a crying mother for 14 hours. That wasn't very nice. So I had a hanky with me. As you know, I don't use many tissues, I actually use hankies. So I always have them stuffed here in my bra. And by the end of that 14-hour flight, it was soaked, absolutely soaked as if it had just been dropped into a bucket. That's how bad it was. And I just decided to leave it on the plane. I wasn't taking that with me to Germany. But the lady that had, yeah, that sat next to me on the flight, she was obviously very disturbed at my crying, asked me what was wrong, and I told her the story that at the airport they'd stopped us, they'd stopped my daughter from getting from boarding the plane, that I'd chosen to push on without her. I was questioning whether my choice as a mother had been the right one. And she obviously had no sort of resolve for that at all. She went on to tell me that she's meeting up with her children on a holiday they'd planned somewhere in the Greek islands. Well, you know, I can say, dear listeners, if you ever find yourself next to an absolutely distraught mother who's crying because they had to leave their children behind with them, they couldn't fly with them, please do not tell them that you are just about to meet up with your children and have a party in the Greek islands. That is not the right thing to do in that kind of a situation.
No,
that made me cry just quite a bit more.
Yeah,
as if I wasn't crying enough already.
Yeah, I would have hugged you, and you could have soaked on my shoulder, like, you know, till the waterfall comes running down my back. So I, you know, and sometimes it's better you just say nothing and wait until the person is ready to talk. Just
well, absolutely. So.
But is everything okay? Have you resolved the problem now?
Because, no, I'm actually still fighting with Qatar. I'm still fighting with Expedia for the refund. I don't believe that we should have to pay, or we should have to forfeit all that money. You know,
yes.
No one told us beforehand that we had to have a 3-month valid passport. That was news
but
to me.
Wait. There is this saying. I don't know how to translate. It's called in Germany, Unwissenheit schützt vor Strafe nicht.
Ignorance,
you know,
what you're saying is that ignorance won't stop a penalty.
Well, Unwissenheit is not ignorance. It's a different, you know, not knowing does not, you know. So it's like the point is, who could have informed you?
Mm-hmm. Well, no
right?
one did. That's the thing. Not Qatar, yeah. Not the airline we flew with, and not Expedia, the booking agent. So neither of those two people informed us at any time that we had to have a certain amount of validity on our passports, or on my daughter's passport before flying.
So I want to tell you something similar on another, like I wanted to fly with Jano to Israel for a month, and I've booked the ticket
already.
For this
upcoming trip.
Yes, so in July for his summer holidays, and I've paid everything already, everything was set, and I tried to get a passport for him, but because he's my grandson and my daughter has, what's it called, Sorgerecht für ihn.
Yeah, so she still has custody. Even though Jana lives with you, she still has custody of the child. Yes.
And I have but the whole responsibility.
Yes.
And she wouldn't say yes. She said, no, I'm not giving my signature. So I cannot get a passport for him right away. I have to go to court, you know, to really get a passport for him.
I had to go through the same thing as well with my children, with both of my children originally.
You
and
see,
then my ex-husband.
Exactly. And now it's like... Jano gets taken by his grandparents and by his grandfather, and I have a whole month without a child. And on one hand, I thought it's sad, but Jano is actually quite okay with the situation. And I said to him, we fly next year for a whole month or for 6 weeks, you and I fly together. Till then, we just prepare. And this time, because I had a very, it's not like the last 2 years are really for me, like, I hope, you know, my last years, I'm thinking, when does it ever pass? When will I feel ever better again? I'm in a basically I'm in quite some despair personally. So I'm glad to fly 4 weeks alone. Mm-hmm. Without a child, and it's for me sanctuary, so I can, you know, be somewhere, cry and scream and write and get down, write down what happened, and he is taken care of, and I have time.
See, but I wasn't at all happy to be flying
without
my children.
No, that's not what I'm saying. I'm just saying it's different for the two of us. You see, it's completely different. It's not the same, but it's like I fly without and I will fly again with him next year. It does not mean, for me it's okay. It's like I'm looking forward because I don't know. It's different. It's different. I'm exhausted. I for me it's like I love my grandson to bits. He's everything to me, but I need just a break. I'm completely, if I would have to have a sanctuary with him, I still care for him. And my person, I'm so broken right now that it's good if I don't have him for a while. I don't know how to explain.
So you just need to find yourself again a little bit
Yeah, I must
next few
get
weeks.
my pieces together and see how life goes on. If I sell the house, if I move on, if I where, how to live on, and make sure he goes to school, and make sure he is. But you wanted to fly with your daughter.
Yeah,
I'm only
absolutely.
telling you this that there are, we have always similar things. Not always, but sometimes life is, we have crossroads and life is exciting in whatever way.
You know,
It's
it's
great.
actually it, it look I get what you're saying, and you know, it turned into a holiday just for myself, really. And I haven't been with myself for a week in many years. I think probably close to 8 years, you know, since Katya was tiny, since she was a baby. So I haven't had any alone time really for, you know, for 8 years. So it was on the one hand, you know, her not coming with me gave me that alone time for a week, but on the other hand, I really wanted to go with her. Like, without her, it just didn't have the same meaning anymore. Like, for the first few days, I was really asking myself, why am I even here? Like, why did I even come? Because she, yeah, absolutely, because she means, you know, so much to me. My children mean so much to me. And, you know, I had gone on the trip because she'd wanted to go to Germany firstly and foremost. And she'd wanted to see everyone again. She was the one who wanted to see more of Germany. And I wanted to be the one to show her, you know, show her Germany. And without her being there, it's sort of, you know, I didn't know what to do with myself, quite honestly. She's like my best friend who suddenly didn't want to come with me, and I didn't know what to, I really just didn't know what to do with myself. Didn't know what to do with my time, almost.
But that's like I'm thinking about the situation because I'm very moved and I, moved by your situation, and I'm glad we had a short time. I'm glad I could hug you in real. That was for me the main thing when I, as soon as I realized she's in Germany, and I was like getting in the car, driving to Marienrode, give you a
Just
hug.
for clarification, I did tell her in time that I
Yeah,
was
and I
coming.
did. I didn't recognize.
She just forgot that I was there. Let's be
No,
honest.
that's not true. I didn't. I couldn't. On like I have things on my schedule
Yeah,
that I
you are very busy. You
couldn't
are very busy.
realize.
It's
I'm
true.
not. My head is too packed with making worries that aren't really worries. So I behave like I wouldn't know God. I'm worrying like crazy, and that's why it's my fault basically. But I'm glad we saw each other. I didn't
Yeah,
forget
me
you.
too. Me too, even if you forgot me.
Terrible. Oh, I'm sorry. I never
I think
can
you
make it
forgot
up
what
to
date it
you.
was. No.
I'm so
I think you
sorry.
forgot what date. No, look, that's fine. And look, I wish we could have met up longer, and it didn't turn up that way. It just didn't turn out that way. We were just all so incredibly busy here and there and everywhere
But
those few
here,
days.
when you talk about it may click in my, the thing is, you've cried your eyes out because you couldn't go with your dearest, okay? And somehow I keep praying for you, and you know about the Father, and just think about it. Whenever, think about it for a moment that Jesus offers you eternal life with him, right? He's my Father. And he does this eternal journey, but if he does it without you, he'll be crying. He is crying actually because you are not his daughter right now, because it's a decision you have to make. He has already done everything to clear the path to eternal life for you, but the decision is yours. Because you don't want, like, if I have a child, I don't want to tell my child, you have to love me because I'm your father. It's like something he's really wanting for you out of your free choice. And that's something you experienced now. It shows you of his, I saw him, I saw his crying eyes once. It's a different matter altogether. It's many years back, but I saw his crying eyes and he is crying for his lost children. And that's just gives you a glimpse of what he suffers for you because he loves you so dearly. You have no idea. I mean, me saying you have no idea is stupid, superficial, because I don't know your heart, your thoughts. But just to explain, you know, how little we know from his eternal love, and the love of the Father is incredible. It's so incredible. Anyhow, that just to give you a glimpse of what it could also mean that you experienced such a dramatic time. But the good point
I couldn't believe it because it felt like my child had just, you know, been ripped away from me. No, she can't come with you.
Yeah.
You know, yeah, and then I felt bad because I really, the responsibility fell onto my shoulders. I had been the one who wrecked her holiday for her. You know, I'd been the one who should have known but didn't know that there were certain rules for Australian passports. Now, then I started getting angry at Craig. You know, I thought, Craig, why won't you let them be dual citizens? Because I've asked him many times. I have asked him many times to let them be European citizens as well, because I think it can only benefit them. And you just never know when the rules are going to change in those circumstances. So I have over the years, I have asked many, many times to allow them to be European citizens, and he's declined. I have spoken to him again since, and he has tentatively agreed, so hopefully this time he sticks to it, and that would make me very happy if both of my children could also be German citizens, not just Australian ones. So, you know, it was over that 14-hour flight, it was a range of emotions, and just to make it a little bit worse, Qatar Airways sat me next to a mother and her child on the one side. I know, that was just devastating.
Just when you thought you finished with crying, huh?
No. So what happens, they stuck me in whichever seat that could get me in the end, because I was the last one to check in ultimately. So they sat me in a row of four. And on the one side, I had the mentally deranged woman who was looking forward to seeing her daughters in Cyprus or wherever. Good on you, mate. And on the other side, I had a mother and her young daughter. And her daughter had also blue eyes and blonde hair, just like Katya, you know, and she's probably 1 or 2 years younger. And then just to make it a little bit worse, you know, the daughter kept falling asleep during this 14-hour flight, and she'd throw her arm over me, and the mother did nothing about it, you know, and then she'd sort of lean, and she was snuggling into me. Obviously, I'm nice and cushy. She probably thought that was a good thing to do. And I had this little strange kid who looked very much like Katya, just snuggling into me this whole 14-hour flight.
Oh, no. Oh, man.
Next to this deranged Cyprus woman who's going to go park with her daughters. So, it was the flight from hell. That was a flight from hell, and all the while, you know, I was thinking, oh, you know, this should be my daughter sitting next to me, you know, this should be my blonde-haired, blue-eyed, you know, daughter sitting next to me, and now I've got this strange Dutch kid, or Polish kid sitting next to something. It was just a terrible flight, a really, really terrible flight.
I did ask you if you teach your children German because of the German stories from Hans Christian Andersen and Die Gebrüder Grimm.
Yeah, but Hans Christian Andersen, he was Danish, wasn't he?
Yeah, but still the stories are European maybe, but the stories are very famous here in Germany, you know, they're
everywhere.
Beautifully...
We're everywhere, but there's a Little Mermaid, that's from Andersen.
Yes, and Walt Disney has made completely such a stupid story out of it. All the stories told, Walt Disney takes it and tells it into something. He takes away the what's it called? Die Moral von der Geschichte, aber es heißt anders. Yeah, but it's not only the moral, but it's the outcome from the story in whatever way. People thought about it and this turns it into something. The world is all nice and fluffy and it will always be a happy end. What is brainwashed by American gold rush fever, or what was his
story? No, of course not, but he wanted to make money, he wanted to make money through entertainment, and he did that incredibly well. So obviously he wasn't stupid, but he needed to be able to sell something to the public in the times of the Depression, because that's when his film started, just after the Depression, just before the World Wars, the Second World War. That's when his films were starting to come out, and he needed to be able to sell them happy stuff, because, you know, at that time people didn't see much happy stuff at all. It was just all blood and guts and war. So he really needed to be able to bring something, some sort of form of entertainment, which he can do beautifully with cartoon. You know, and he brought that into the public, you know, and it was exactly what they needed, exactly what they wanted to see, happiness and happy endings and good times and all that sort of stuff. And
All
that's
right,
yeah.
I personally don't like him that much. The old Disney movies I like, but I saw movies, you know, Shirley Temple, that little actress.
Yeah, Shirley Temple.
Yeah, and I
Absolutely.
saw
The
movies
dwarf.
where, I can show you scenes out of Shirley Temple with adults where pedophile scenes in it. Very bad, very, very bad. Where they,
Oh, no, I
she
don't need to
was.
see that. But
Only well, I don't show you. I'm just telling you because
thank
she was used actually to that money part and the fantasy of men in that scene, in that movie scene, to make money. They go beyond kosher thoughts, beyond kosher
But it was different. It was
stories.
different times, though, wasn't it? It was different times, because back then it was acceptable, you know, just on the subject of sexuality and how women were
Wow.
on how women were sexualized. Back in the Shirley Temple days, it was normal for men to slap girls' butts, you know, out in public even, and
That's
you know,
ridiculous,
well,
yeah.
that's how it was, and they were expected to giggle about it. Hee, oh, that was funny, you know. And but that was the morale of the time, and that was
But
acceptable. It
that it
was
was
different
accepted
times, yeah.
doesn't mean that it was okay. You see, that it was accepted doesn't mean that it was good.
No, I'm not saying it was. All I'm saying, I'm not saying it was bad either. What I'm saying is that that was the sign of the time. That's how it was back in those days. You
It
know,
hasn't changed.
no, and I wouldn't say that. I think
Well, I would say
the
that.
world it absolutely has changed.
In
Absolutely.
what sense? In what matter?
Well, in the sense that men don't go around slapping women's butts anymore. You know,
Well, yeah,
you don't
there
do
is
that. I mean,
more
yeah.
awareness, but
There is that
they
much
do it
more
in
awareness.
secret. They do it in secret and in their, if you see how the industry has developed. If you can speak about development in that sense, then it's become even worse, you know, because women are after all seen as sexual objects, which we are not at the children's we still are not at the children's wir sind immer noch nicht bei der Kindersendung angelangt.
We still haven't started the children. Yeah, I don't think this episode is going to be a child's version.
No, it's
To be
not.
honest,
So
I
we
think
have
we've
to
lost that
We've lost
opportunity.
the, yeah, that's true. So you have to be the beginning. Yeah, that's true.
And
I'm sorry for
we
that.
should probably explain why we actually wanted to make like an older children's show. We did want to
Yeah.
dedicate a show to older children, and the reason was because this morning I was eating breakfast with my children. We were having our eggs and our Rye-vita. And our salami cheese, it actually is called salami cheese, even though it has nothing to do with salami. But they all of a sudden told me, "Mum," and this is word for word, fair dinkum, right? They turn around and they said to me, "Do you still talk to Auntie?" This was Heidi, so I'll just tell you exactly what she said. "Mum, do you still talk with Auntie? What's her name?" And then And Katya says, "Yeah, you know the one you did the talks with." And then Heidi said, "Yeah, she's not an auntie. Her name's not auntie, but what's her name? What's her name?" And I said, "Bianca? You mean do the podcast with Bianca?" Yeah, that's the one, Bianca." Don't hold it against them, you know. They're not great with names.
It's sweet, it's
And
totally sweet. They don't need to remember my name. As long as they have fun with the stuff behind it,
Yeah,
it's
well,
good.
wait, just hang on, let me keep. And I said, "No, actually, Bianca, she hasn't, we haven't done a podcast in about 7 months, Heidi, you know."
Right.
And then she says, "Why?" And I said, "Well, I don't think Bianca has much time." I might as well be honest with you, that's what I told them. And I said, "Yeah, I don't think Bianca has much time." And then she says, they both said, "Oh." And then the sweetest thing that you could ever hear from your children, Heidi says to me, because sometimes we listen to your podcasts. And I turn around to them, I said, really? And Katya says, yeah, on our iPads, we listen, we just keep listening to your podcasts. And I said, really? You listen to our podcasts? Oh, yeah, we listen to them all the time, and we just sit there on our iPads and we listen to your podcasts. And we really like them, they're really good. And obviously we've had mostly adult content, so I was a little bit surprised at that. To be honest, I'm surprised they even found us online, because they all have their own YouTube accounts, so they must have sort of actively searched for us. But they that was just like the sweetest thing that your children could tell you, is that they love your work. You know, to have that coming from your children, you know, and any, you know, 1,000 people could tell you that they love your work. But when you hear it from your own children, that's like gold in your hand. You know, you couldn't ask for anything better. So that was something that really touched me this morning. And I thought, well, we have to keep this going. You know, even if Auntie Bianca doesn't have any time, I have to come somehow keep this going.
Ouch.
Oh, well, it's
Ouch.
true, isn't it? Well, that's all
No,
right.
it's yeah, it's like I'm was soaked in too many problems,
You've
so it's
got
just,
too
but
much
it's no
stuff.
excuse for not having time. I actually, that's the point. I'm very mad with a friend because he never takes time really, because he hasn't got any, I don't know. And I'm behaving just the same, complaining about him. I'm not better. You know, I see like der Splitter on Balken. I see his blind and don't see my own what's the Balken in English?
Like a beam that holds things
Yeah, I don't
together.
see my own beam before my eyes, you know? That's exactly the point. So no. It must it's good to take time. I must get my
Well, I think
head
if
setting
this
right.
you know, for our fans, absolutely, you know, as you're actually personally friends with one of our fans, Stephen Hunt, and he's been waiting and waiting and waiting and waiting
Yeah.
for another episode. And I'm probably sure, you know, some of our podcasts in the first season, they actually had over 2,500 listeners. So, you know, that I didn't actually realize that till I got to
Was
Germany.
100, 2000,
Yeah,
100.
2,500. 100,000? Did it?
Nee, 100 people,
No, 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 no,
listeners.
no, no. Gudrun actually showed me, because I showed her our channel, and I honestly hadn't looked into this since you left. So after you left, that was well. I didn't have my partner with me, so I didn't bother looking into it anymore. So I once you left and you didn't come back, I didn't look into the podcast anymore either. And over the last, you know, good 7 months since before Christmas, Gudrun actually made me aware of this while I was in Germany, that one of them had 2,500 listeners
Really?
over the Facebook platform. Yeah. So obviously
Oh.
we are being listened to. Someone must be missing us,
Interesting.
and I
I
know that
thought
my children are.
that is actually wow, that is the sweetest thing I've heard in quite a while. Absolutely sweet. And it's a golden nugget, as you said. It's gold. Gold, pure gold. You couldn't have any better things in life than those moments. Those are golden moments.
Oh, that was absolutely, and I hadn't even known. I didn't even know that they were listening to us. You know, I
Isn't that
hadn't,
great?
you know, I'd always wondered what they were doing with their iPads, and they were listening to our podcasts, and
Isn't that
that's just
cool?
beautiful. And to have your children say that they actually love your work, and that's just absolutely amazing. And that's all the reason you need really to keep going, if not for your other fans as well.
And
Absolutely
it
for
is
the other
not,
fans. We
and it
love
is
our
not.
fans.
Yeah, it's of course, and the point is even it reminds me on doing better research, being more aware in life. And again, I must say that the friendship Ingrid and I are having is growing, developing.
Just not over
And
the last 7 months, but yeah, now today it is.
rub it in, baby, rub it in. Yeah, but you're right. You're completely right. That's exactly the point. Sometimes it's, you know, I can only offer an apology. It's completely my fault. I take the whole blame. Okay.
Okay,
So,
good.
okay. So if you know
I'm
how I can
glad we're
make
clear
it,
on that one.
Okay, yeah, completely. It's and I don't really have an explanation. It was just bad. I can't even, you know, it was my fault. Okay, and end of the quote. And you are my friend, so and there is no excuse apart from a lousy apology. So if I can make it up to you, let me know. As I said, if you come on holidays with your daughters, you can always crash in my place.
Thank you.
It's wheelchair friendly, right?
Oh, well, sort of.
Well, if you say you come in a month's time, I may sort of. It's Heidi can go on the toilet. I can wash her up here.
Yeah.
I can even, you can take a shower here. So it would be all it would functioning.
Yeah, that's always an issue, with places being wheelchair friendly, because I don't go on holiday a lot. But when I do with both of my kids, and the reason I didn't, just for our listeners, because they're probably wondering, hang on, you have another kid, you know, an older kid who's in a wheelchair, and she wasn't coming, where was she? She wasn't coming to Germany with you? Calm yourselves. So, yes, I absolutely do have another daughter, an elder daughter who's in a wheelchair. Hello, Heidi, in case you're listening to this podcast.
Many kisses to you, Heidi, and many kisses to Katja, of course.
So,
from Aunt Bianca.
Yes,
the terrible aunt.
Even if she's not really
months.
An auntie, kisses from Aunt
why not?
Bianca. No, anyway.
I adopt you.
An auntie. Okay, we'll add you to our list of 200 aunties. Now, what actually? That's the whole reason why we actually decided to come to Germany for a week, back in May/June, was because Heidi was away on a class trip to Canberra. And she was going to be there, Canberra, for those not all that familiar with Australia. Canberra is the Hauptstadt, or the main city of Australia. So it's the capital city. And she was going there with her classmates and her teachers and her aides for a whole week, which was amazing. She'd been looking forward to that for months since she found out, you know, just the excitement of being with a group of her friends and her class away from home for a week. So I thought, you know, this is perfect timing, you know, let's go, why don't I and Katja go on a much needed holiday? Because, you know, Katja doesn't get out that much either. You know, Heidi certainly does go on many more trips than Katja ever does through her school as well. So I thought this would be the perfect time for, you know, for Katja and I just to go away. So that's where my older daughter was. It's not like I purposely pushed her back, or not like I purposely wouldn't let her come with me. No, no, no. She was on a class trip. She was having fun. She was having the time of her life in Canberra. That's where she
You're
was.
A wonderful mother. Don't worry. You're an example to me about good mothers. Good like good. How a mother should be.
I'd say I'm far from it. I'm far from the perfect mother, and I know I'm not the perfect mother.
Well, you're a good mother. I didn't say perfect, I say good.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, I try, you know.
You're very good.
Probably
you're
not
a good
always.
Mother.
Sometimes
but
I
you,
just
you
think,
really,
oh,
you
fuck
really
it.
Care, you really care for your kids. You really care for your kids. It's wonderful to
Well,
to
they're
see.
They're like my best friends, you know, and they are my kids, and I understand that I have like a formal responsibility over them, you know, and I'm certainly I can't always keep my cool. I bloody well try, you know. I try to be always very even tempered, and to even spoken, you know, softly spoken with them as a kind mother should be, you know, but sometimes that doesn't plan out. You know, that doesn't always work. Just ask my kids.
Because you're not robot. Sure.
No, you can't always be a robot. That's true. Especially when there's feelings involved, and you know, you're in a home situation. So, but I do. That's what I aim to be. I aim to be a good mother, so they'll never be able to turn around and say what a shit mother she was. So, and I really hope that my, you know, I can make the same sort of loving people, kind people out of my children. Absolutely.
Have you got a Bible in English, a children's Bible?
Yeah, we've got a
in
few.
English?
We've got a few, actually.
Wow, amazing. And are your kids reading in it?
No.
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 So it's just there to have a Bible in the house?
No. Look, we have every now and then we do take a look in it, you know, if we have a reason. And as I think you know, and I've mentioned in previous episodes, that we, for a while, we were actively church going. We used to go every Sunday and every Friday. We used to have our home group through the church as well. We were actively doing that for quite a while, and we stopped doing that, and we haven't gone back, and that's been okay. It's been absolutely okay, because I tell you what, they made us feel like absolute shit, and
isn't that terrible?
We feel better without it. It doesn't mean we pay God any less respect or anything like that.
I understand.
We're not doing that anymore.
Yeah, that was the time. Like now in my church, I go there to be a blessing. I don't really receive much. I got used to it, not receiving. I decided to be a blessing instead. I get very good sermons out of YouTube from excellent. There is Dr. Darius Daniel. He is an awesome African preacher, African American. He's American preacher, and he's just encouraging me. You know, I need to hear good sermons so I can survive my days. I don't get that in my church. I'm playing music now. I'm in a music group. We practice every Wednesday, 3 hours. That's my survival gear. And on three Sundays, I do kids school in my church. So I don't really receive sermon, but I clean the church when I clean our, you know, congregation house to be a blessing. I make breakfast tomorrow morning, because we have every Sunday breakfast, 9 o'clock. And that's what I decided. I know there are people who pray for me, because I'm in a difficult situation. But now I've spoken to a few other sisters in Christ, and like women with difficult situations, and there are women who live in even worse situations than I ever could imagine. Like one lady, she has a disabled husband. He had strokes and he cannot walk proper. He has lost some of his logical brain stuff. He's a very, very harsh man. And she has two kids, foster kids, two brothers. And she is not looking very good. And she toughens up and she sticks to the Lord. And that is for me. We decided now that we are like four or five women. We have a WhatsApp group, and we decided to encourage each other so we don't lose faith and hope in all. And in our despair, we can encourage us. And finally, through going what each of us has to go through, learning the lessons in life, we find laughter, we find joy back. You know, we can hug. I listen to her, she listens to me. You know what I mean? Like we encourage each other. Don't give up. You're just fine. It's just the devil is a liar. The devil is a destroyer. He hates God's children. He hates mankind in genuine, and he wants to destroy. You know, he wants to destroy humans. That's his main goal in life anyway. And he knows he hasn't got much time left, so he's raging like crazy. But for us, it's good. We opened this group for one or two weeks ago. It was an idea just to give us courage, you know. There's one lady, she has a disabled child. The daughter has to wear a helmet not to hit herself. I don't know what she has, but she's badly disabled. And she has other difficult things going on. And
I have to give kudos to these mothers, to these parents who have such severely. And I've always wondered out of my mind how these parents do it, because I don't think I would be able to. I personally don't think I would be able to do that. You know, for to be a parent, a good parent to a child who has no sort of idea what's going on. You don't even know how much is going in there, you know, when you're even speaking to them.
She can't speak properly. She's only giving, you know, she's making noises. I don't know what's all, but it's she's taken good care of. And the point is to take this mother. She hasn't even time. She has for 2 years. I've given her years back. She received, it wasn't from me, I don't know who gave, this face mask, you know? And she told me she didn't even had time to put this face mask on her face. She didn't even have time, 15 minutes for herself, because she's so concerned about her family. And this really gets me, you know? This really
Yeah,
gets me because,
absolutely. Because it really it puts it into realization, doesn't it? And as an outsider who has no disabled children or anything like that, it's very, very hard to fathom. And I see that time and time again, you know, from parents or other people who might not even have any children, who want to keep giving me advice on parenting or on my parenting skills. And I just think, get a life.
Walk in your shoes for
Or
half
that
a
you have
day
no
and
idea.
speak to me.
That's right. Look, it's very easy, and I get the where they're coming from. I know a few people who perhaps they don't even have any children. They'd really like some. They can't have any, and just you can just tell that their criticisms, come from a place where they think they could do parenting better, but really they have no idea. And you have no idea what it's like being a parent until you have done it yourself with your own offspring, and then to mix a disabled child into the parenting mix, adds a whole nother dynamic as well. And then, you can go further by saying there's all sorts of different disabilities and severities and all that. I've been pretty lucky, in the sense that my disabled daughter is in a wheelchair simply because she doesn't have use of her legs, but everything else seems to work okay. But there are plenty of parents who I would never, ever dare give any kind of advice to because I know I wouldn't be able to understand the first thing of what they're going through, and I wouldn't be able to do it, and these amazing parents, they go through, a lot of them never even get to leave their own house because they're stuck there with a child who's perhaps can't talk. You don't even know if he's listening. Don't know if he can see anything. He can't. It's non-responsive. Gets fed through a tube, perhaps. It can't. Certainly can't walk or move. And they hang. They stick to it, day after day, day in, day out. And
Around the
I.
clock,
These are exceptional people. Like really,
Yeah, that's
I
true.
that's absolutely exceptional people, and I tell you what, I wouldn't do it. I personally wouldn't do it, but these people do it. These wonderful people have given up their whole lives, for their child or their disabled relative, perhaps even sometimes, who's in a really bad way, and they sacrifice themselves, often with little help. With little help or no
Isn't
help,
that like
perhaps.
the song from Depeche Mode, Try Walking in My Shoes? You know this one?
I like Depeche Mode, but I don't know that song.
Ah, you must listen to it and it's really Try Walking in My Shoes. It's nice song because he went
I
to.
know the song Free Love. That's pretty good
All right.
from Depeche Mode. Do you know
I
that
don't
one?
know this one.
Oh,
No,
see,
no.
that's my kind of song. I
Ah,
like Free Love. Free Love is a good
Free Love.
song.
I must listen to this one. Cool, cool. So that's like basically basically really nothing to add to it.
Where were we?
Give me a cigarette. Give me a puff of your smoke.
Have one. I'll send it to you in email. I'll send it as
All right. I'm
attachment.
glad I see the smoke crossing my
The webcam.
what's it called?
Yeah, because for listeners who have just tuned in, we can actually see ourselves. You can't see us. Nah, 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 nah. But we can see each other when we're talking to each other, and that way we can see our eyebrow cues, when we want to sort of like to stop talking about that, or we can when we do the hand across the neck, no, shut up, we can sort of see our own cues, and we can, yeah, it's
So back to the like we fly out slowly of this podcast. Back to the flight you had this I'm still with you where you said you got changed and washed and got ready to you dressed yourself to get ready to Hannover
Oh,
after
this was like
such a
half an hour ago, Bianca.
Yeah, but
We're back on the
that's
subject.
how I wanted to end. That's how I wanted to finish this cast because I like the way you just got freshed up. You had your bad cry very long. You got freshed up. You changed your clothes. You went to Hannover, and had a very, very excellent time with your friends.
It was fantastic. Well,
A really fantastic
look,
time.
it was good. Actually, it was good seeing my family again. It was really good seeing my family again. And interestingly, when I have no idea how we got into this conversation, but I had
Me
when no 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 when I got back,
neither.
when I got back to Melbourne, I actually had someone ask me, and I don't speak an awful lot to this person. I have no idea how we got into this conversation, but they asked me, where for you is home, or what do you consider your home? Where do you consider your home?
Ah.
And I'd never really thought about that before, and I just took a minute and I sort of stared out the window and I had to have a think about that one. But I'd have to say, out of all the places, it would have to be somewhere close to Hildesheim, Malina Water. And I
Wow.
say, look, it's a difficult question to answer. That is, for me, it's a super difficult question to answer, and a question that totally threw me off because, no one had asked. And just to think, we, as a child, my parents and I used to move around from country to country every 3 years, 2.5, 3 years. So we were constantly on the move. And there'd be very, very few places that I could say, yeah, I mean, obviously I live here in Australia now. I was born here. I've lived here for the last 13 years. I've started a family here. I'm raising a family here. But where would I really consider my home? And, in that moment, I think I got back to the saying, home is where the heart is. So just because, I live here in Australia or here in Doveton, certainly doesn't mean that that's where your heart is. And I had to think, where is my heart? Where did I leave my heart? Well, actually, I probably lost it somewhere, in Hildesheim, Malina Water, where my auntie and my uncle have been there, and I've known them since I was tiny, and every opportunity I had, growing up as a child, every holiday opportunity, we would go back there. Certainly in the last, 13, 12 years, every time I've travelled somewhere, I've always travelled back to Friedrich and Heidi. I just realised, actually, after being asked that question, like, and having, after all that trouble with Expedia, going through my plane flight history, I'd realised every time I'd gone somewhere with a plane, I'd gone back there to
You
see
know what
them
I.
and to see my friends. And I, from a sort of a sentimental point of view, that would have to be my home,
Yeah.
outside of the physical space here where I work, where I live here in Doveton. That would have to be the sentimental place where I've always gone back to them, or I've always felt happy seeing them, seeing my cousins, building up such a huge friendship group as well over the years. It was interesting.
When you said, when that person asked you where your home is and you looked out of the window, I remember what you wrote about when you were in Hong Kong and you sat in a cafe and your parents sat on one table. I only say this to you for what a moment I caught. And you had a smoothie and were drinking your
No,
smoothie and were looking out of.
that wasn't in Hong Kong.
No, where was it?
You're right. I'm sorry. It was in Lama
Ah,
Island in Hong Kong, and my parents
okay.
weren't actually at the next table. They had gone somewhere totally
Yeah.
different. They were on the other end of the island. They'd
Yeah.
left me in that vegan cafe
Okay,
with
so
my
that's
smoothie.
just the moment I remember. That's all I wanted to say. Another thing, two days ago, Thursday, we've been at Gudrun's place, and David came with his kids. I saw
David
the
Ops.
baby.
So
Yeah.
my cousin David we're talking about now, and
Yeah.
our mutual friend Gudrun.
Yeah, and we together, David, put up the trampoline, and I helped him
Oh
in the
yeah,
end.
the Belgium trampoline. Yeah, that's
Yeah, and
right.
there were like 13 people. I don't know, 3 adults, 10 kids. It was packed. It
Jesus
was
Christ.
just lovely. It was so lovely. It was amazing. My little one
They
was
don't
playing with the
sell
boys.
contraception in Hildesheim.
Hmm?
They don't sell contraception in Hildesheim.
No, we don't need that. We really love children here. You see,
Yeah,
that's
apparently you
our.
do. I'm sure that sounds like
We
you do.
sure do. So if you don't want, if anybody doesn't know what to do with kids, bring them to us. We take them all in. So
We'll give you her address at the end of the
yes, sure. Bring them
podcast.
all to me. I take them all in.
Don't do
So,
it.
but that was lovely. That was just a very nice. Also to see the little baby, the darling Ronja,
Yeah,
and
so this is my cousin David, we should explain. He's the well, he's the
oldest of Heidi and Friedrich, the
he's
oldest
my
son of
oldest
Heidi
he's my
and Friedrich.
oldest blood cousin. So because
Yeah.
there's a few other boys there that come from a first marriage. Now David is my oldest blood cousin, so he's 3 years younger than me. So that still puts him in his late 20s, but already by now he's managed to have how many kids?
Four.
Four kids. He's
Lovely
planning the
father.
fifth one.
He is, you know, I think that he said four is enough, but
Well,
one never knows.
he also said that after the second one. He also said
Ah,
two's
nice to
enough,
know.
and then
I
came the
must
third and
tell
the
him this.
fourth. You
But
know, they
like
sort of
the
keep popping out, and we don't know how.
you see, he had his the Ronja was crying, and he had this little Ronja on his arms and was, you know, checking the trampoline, and he was caring. It was lovely to watch him, how he cared for his children, and how he it was just really lovely seeing him, and he has grown into a beautiful, beautiful man and father. Lovely to see. And Tara is making her driving license.
Yeah, that's great news, isn't it?
Wonderful.
That
Wow,
the
his wife. Tara is his
Mum
wife.
Tara. That's right.
Yeah,
She's
she
mum
is
to
the
the
mother from
four
those four
children.
children. Very, very lovely people. Incredible people.
Yeah.
So, like,
I
women never stop
I
talking.
will say that they really do have four beautiful children, and the issue is because I've got one 12-year-old now and I've got a 9-year-old, and I'm still I'm still in my early 30s. Actually, I had my children very young, and I'm still in my early 30s. And when I see little babies, I get clucky, and that's always been, especially the last couple of years.
Yeah.
I notice more and more so that I'm getting cluckier when I see little babies, and there's nothing I can do about it because I'm single. But you know,
I stop smelling babies before they get the first wash. This typical baby
oh, you
smell.
sniff babies. You're a baby
Oh, I
sniffer.
stopped that because it does something with my brain, and I stopped sniffing babies. I just hold them, and I like them a lot, but if I sniff on them, it's like I'm gone. Give me a baby.
I think they smell
You know,
horrible.
this mother thing, something in my brain is like
Yeah, you get clucky. You get clucky.
That's the
And
word. Okay.
that's for me, because also I'm turning 32 this year. And I'm watching the clock, and there's no rush. You know, I keep saying there's no rush. You know, I have to get married first. I have to find someone first, and then think about there. But I also don't want to pass the point where my kids are both, you know, adults, and then start thinking, do I actually want another family member? Do I want to have another child? And anyway, so where was I? When the issue was, David's kids are so beautiful, I
Yeah.
could not help myself getting clucky. And they have a little boy there, one of their boys, and I'll say this now because
Finn?
no, how'd you know? I almost wanted to pack him into my suitcase. I asked him a few times, "You want to jump into my suitcase with me?" Because he's the most Finn, and Finn is this he's second youngest, isn't he? He's the second
Yeah.
youngest. Finn, it's a boy. His name's Finn, and he's just the most gorgeous, gorgeous
Dessert.
child, you know,
Yeah.
you could ever wish for. And you know,
Yeah.
he oh geez, he's the little boy that I never had, that I wanted to pack into my suitcase with me and take him home. Sounds creepy, I know, but you know, it's certainly he was just so adorable. And every time Auntie Heidi was telling me that he was just crazy for me, you know, every time he walked in the door and I wasn't there because I was in Hanover or Hildesheim or somewhere else, he'd rush into their door saying, "Where's Ingrid? Where's Ingrid?" And even when we went to visit them at his house, he was actually hanging out of their window, their bedroom window, saying, "Ingrid's here." And that was just absolutely adorable. And you know,
Yeah.
he's a little ray of sunshine, that kid,
Yeah,
but
totally.
really, really cute.
While I was doing the trampoline, he came always asking, "Can I go on it now? Can I go on it?" And then he started talking to me and just telling things. Oh, he's just so lovely.
Isn't he?
Re
Out
really.
of the four children,
Yeah,
out of the
he's amazing.
four ox children, that little boy, he's just absolutely, he's a love muffin. He's just
Yeah.
so lovable, that little Finn. The other three,
So.
well, Ronya's too young, but the other two I feel a little bit standoffish now. But Finn's absolutely, he's just a gem. He's
It's
just
just
absolutely
Finn.
a gem. It is just
Yeah.
Finn. It is just Finn, you know. Well, I offered them to him, you know, if you ever want to send him on a trip to Australia, no guarantee you'll get him back or anything, but you know,
Yeah.
it's please, you know.
So
Certainly,
we Nima invited everyone to come to the States.
oh, did he?
I had breakfast. I saw him for breakfast on Wednesday in a
Yeah, and
quesia.
Nima is an old friend of ours. He's Who actually, well, he's been in Germany for so long, actually. How did he, when did he actually start getting into the church? Because I know that he was actually given refuge He was given sanctuary in the church, and that's how we met him, because he
Yeah,
had
but he's
sanctuary
born
in
in
the church,
Mainz.
but he
He's
was born
born
in
in
Mainz
Mainz,
in Germany,
but
but
his
he's
parents are
Persian.
from
They're actually
Persian.
Persian.
Yeah.
So he's actually
Yeah.
Persian. He was born in, it's a very complicated story. He's actually Persian. He was born in Mainz, though. And when we met him through the church because he'd been given sanctuary there.
Yeah.
And
And
he was there for many years. Many years, he's
sixteen
there.
years ago he moved to the States.
So just no.
Yes,
Couldn't have been
yes,
that
yes.
long because I
It
left
is.
Germany 15 years ago and he was still there when I was there.
Well, he has a daughter, she's 14,
Yeah, well,
and
he got right
he
onto it.
moved. He said he moved to the States when he was 30, and now he's 46. So he has a daughter, she's 14. He was like meeting his wife in America. So I met his wife and his daughter, Nadia and Gloria. Very lovely.
Yes. Yeah.
So
And this is the first time he's gone on a trip with him, I think, isn't it? Certainly to Germany, and I
yeah.
know now that they were in Hildesheim for just under a week, and now they've gone to Cyprus for
Yeah.
not sure for how long, but I imagine it was very nice seeing him again, and I would have loved to have seen him. It's just too bad he couldn't
So
come a couple of weeks earlier
yeah,
while I was there.
it was really a close shave, isn't it? Like you would have
Yeah,
always
we're
met.
flying against each other. Yeah,
Yeah.
it was a bummer. It was a bummer. I would have loved to
So
have said hello again.
yeah. This was incredible,
And
very incredible.
Nemo's now some sort of a architectural planner, isn't he? Like he's
Yeah.
got some sort of a high-nose job now, and
Yeah.
he's been doing that for quite a few years. He had his own business for a while. He had his own business for a little while, and then he gave that up, and became like a state planner or an architect, something along those lines. But yeah, I imagine that he would have been very, very happy to see everyone again after all that time.
Oh yes,
Yeah.
it's just to get a glimpse of that was fine with me. It was very nice, very, very nice to hug his wife, to see his daughter. It's just lovely.
Did he spend any time up in the Osterberg?
No, he
He didn't.
didn't have the
Okay.
time. No. He tried to, but he was very busy. So
Yeah, I can
no, he
imagine
didn't.
because he
Yeah,
also had connections with while he was here originally,
a
16
lot.
years ago.
Yeah.
He had a lot of connections with the Persians and the other churches as well. So
I
he
mean,
wasn't just ecclesia
it's
he
a
was
little bit
visiting.
like he said, for 5 minutes he tried. I would have loved that he comes here and sees what has changed, because we've done a lot of work here. It has changed incredibly, because he knows the Osterberg when it was, trashy. I say it was a
Oh,
very
really?
trashy place. Yes, completely.
Okay.
You should have seen when we moved here. It was
It was
very
gone.
trashy.
Yeah, well, yeah. Okay.
I mean, you had 100 car wheels lying around, and a lot of trash, and the way it looked here, it was just unbelievable. So we did a lot of work, and I would have liked him to see what we've done with the place. And exactly now, the roses are in blossom. It's all flowers in blossom. It's
I
very,
imagine
very
it would
lovely.
look absolutely beautiful in summertime.
Yeah, the it's just become a lovely place. But anyway, we had breakfast in the Ecclesia, and it was lovely. And all I wanted to see is, who is he got married to? What does his daughter is like? And
Haven't you seen them yet? Haven't you seen photos of them?
I sent you a photo from to Messenger from Nima, his wife and his daughter and me, if you like.
Yeah. But
Okay, I do that.
what I'm saying is, hadn't you seen them before that point?
No.
Oh, really? I've known what they've I've known what Gloria,
Ah, I
but she looks
didn't.
like she's tiny. So
Ah, she
I've
looks
watched her
like a.
grown up. I've watched her grow up over the years, because
Yes, she looks like a Persian princess to me. She does.
well, she definitely looks Persian.
Yeah,
Yeah, definitely looks
like
Persian. Yeah.
with her long black hair, and she's got the eyebrows a bit like Frida Kahlo. Very interesting, beautiful eyebrows.
Frida Kahlo, you reckon?
Yeah, sure.
I'll have to have another look at the picture afterwards.
Yeah, very, very beautiful. So nice, nice, nice. Right, you want to close up?
I do. I think we
I
should.
mean, I could talk to you for ages, I could sit here for the rest of my life and talk to you. So,
And
but our listeners.
I think, well, why don't we call this season two? Season two of Bianca and Ingrid. And
Yeah.
I think we should finished the first episode with an adult fairy tale to send everyone off into their days. We can, which, did you want to do Rapunzel?
No, I've changed my mind.
You don't like Rapunzel anymore?
No, not really. I don't have time to grow my hair so long, so I don't have time to get into the meaning. Something else. What do you like?
No. What I was thinking,
I like The Little Mermaid, actually, but I like many stories.
What I was thinking of is we don't need to get into the meaning of it. We just tell the story in our own way. So I will tell one piece of the story, and then you can follow with your version of another piece of the story, and we'll just flow along, and we'll make up a story together as we go. Well, of our own adult version of this fairy tale. What do you reckon?
But does it have to be Rapunzel? No.
No, I'm just saying Rapunzel because that's what you said before.
So how about Sterntaler? I don't know in English.
Yeah, I'm not too versed on that story. I'd just be making up a whole lot of shit if
Right, then just Cinderella is one I like.
All right, we all know Cinderella. Do you want to start off?
I don't know how. You are the good one in telling stories.
I'll start off and then you follow.
Okay, yes, yes.
Let me clear my voice. Everyone listening? Good. So, once upon a time in a land far, far away, even further away than Australia, there was a young girl called Ella. Her name was Ella.
Ella?
Ella, yes.
Okay.
Ella.
Ella?
Ella.
Okay. Ella.
Ella, okay. Alter. Ella. Ella.
Ohne Alter.
And just Ella.
Okay, Alter. Ella, Alter.
Alles Ella, klar. Alter. No, it's just Ella. Her name was just Ella. Just Ella with a J.
I listen.
With a J. Just Ella. And then what happened? Then you have to tell the next part. So I've told my sentence now.
Okay, and little Ella had twin sisters. No.
It's a new twist. No, let's keep going. It's a new twist on the story. So Ella
has twin
sisters.
Because I know a real Ella who just happened to have twin sisters more than a week ago. No, I'm sorry, I tell you that story another time. I sent you a picture from little Ella with her twin sisters later. Okay, and little Ella was born and her mother died because the birth was so heavy. Isn't that the story?
That's right, because she died. Ella's head was so big. Ella's head was so big that she couldn't make it out on her own, and then the mother tore, and then she got an infection and she died.
That's very sad. So the father stood alone with his little girl and decided to marry someone else, and don't know where he left his senses, but he married a woman with this woman brought two girls with her.
Yes.
And cut the long story short. No, we don't cut the long story short.
No, we're making a story. Don't cut it short.
Okay.
We're making the story.
I'm sorry.
So you should be. So he married this woman that had two daughters already, and he thought this would be somehow, in his wisdom, he thought that this would be an excellent idea, because let's face it, he wasn't the best at changing diapers. He really needed someone to change the diapers for him on Ella. She shout like a raccoon, and the two other girls that were meant as compadres or companions for little Ella to play with. So it was all in good, you know. He meant it all well. Everything that he did, you know, he thought everything was going to work out perfectly, but of course it didn't.
Yeah, he saw to his pink glasses and didn't really recognize what kind of harsh woman this stepmother of Ella was.
Because, I mean, he hadn't had sex in a while, you know, and he saw this woman as great.
Oh, there we go. You're a hopeless case, really.
So and you know, love makes us blind, you know, and he thought, oh my God, yeah, she's the next best one. You're on.
Eros love makes us blind. Agape love makes us see. That's right. It's different.
And in those days, you couldn't have sex before marriage, which is why he had to. Well, there we go. There's your answer. He had to marry her because you couldn't have sex before marriage, and that's how Ella, poor Ella, ended up with his evil stepmother, and two evil twin sisters apparently from a different mother.
That they couldn't doesn't mean that people did not have this intimacy without being married, so it
What?
doesn't really.
What are
Of
you
course,
talking about?
people went without marriage into bed with each
No,
other
you're
and at
joking.
any
Tell me you're
time.
joking. Tell me you're joking. That's not true. That's not true.
That's for sure. It's true.
Wouldn't dream of
It
it.
always has
Wouldn't
been.
dream of it. Ugh,
People
come.
had intimacy with each other before
Oh, I
marrying.
don't want to hear about
There
this
were
smut.
always exceptions.
Now
There
you're
are
getting smutty.
always
You are
exceptions.
getting
Always.
smutty. Listen to yourself, woman. Control yourself.
No, that's true. I can give you an example from the
No.
Tanakh, from the Old Testament,
No.
where people went to bed with
No,
each
I
other
don't believe
without
it.
being married.
It's a typo. I don't believe it. No.
It's true.
There's no sex before
I send
marriage.
you the passage later. Anyway,
No.
so this poor guy married because he thought on moral aspects, and he couldn't really see the true heart of the woman. The
Well,
woman was
actually,
very
the
harsh.
woman, she was pressing for it. She was the one
Yeah.
who was probably a little bit smarter than the guy, let's face it. She wasn't the one under pressure with the baby. So she turned around and said, "You know what? No one's gonna buy the ice cream if you get the whole ice cream van for free." So she said, "Let's get married. Otherwise, there's no hanky panky." And so that's exactly what he did.
Yes,
That's what he did.
and so Ella grew up, and this little the stepmother and her daughters mistreated Ella badly, and Ella was raised as a servant girl. So she was living somewhere in the kitchen. She had to do the work. She had to bring the ashes out, and she was still a brave-hearted little girl who sang songs and feed the doves and cared for the animals and really was lovely. And she went sometimes to the grave of her mother and cried. And there suddenly a fairy appeared, a good mother fairy appeared. Wasn't that the case?
Anyway,
Wasn't that when somehow that she turned the pumpkin into the coach?
yes. Well, anyway, so she's crying at the. Let's just take a step back there for a minute. So
Okay.
the father died. Okay, let's not forget that the father actually. This is a crucial part of the
Did he die?
story. Yes, the father died, which is how she ended up in the kitchen. Otherwise, she would have still been
Okay.
in her lovely princess bedroom, but she
Ah,
wasn't.
okay.
She was.
I missed that point.
Yeah,
Okay.
she became a servant to the family, and she had to sleep in the cinder soot, which is why she was called Cinderella. Yeah, because she was made to Aschenputtel, because she was meant sent to sleep in the asher or the cinders of the kitchen hearth, and that's how she became known as Cinderella. And after the father died, the wealthy the widow became very rich, and because she wasn't, her own daughter, she sent her to sleep in the cinders. And then there was the aspect of the royal ball. Now, the prince of the kingdom was looking for a bride, and he decreed everyone in the kingdom, every eligible young maiden, to come to the ball for a dance-off until 4 a.m.
And he wanted them all.
And he wanted
He
them
wanted
all, every
every
last girl.
single young girl
The
to be at his
insatiable
party.
girl. That's right.
Yes.
Insatiable girl. He was an insatiable prince, and he wanted everyone to be there, even to the last scullery maid. So
So
of
he
course,
sent his messengers on horses to the valleys, to the villages, and they were reading, proclaiming on the marketplaces.
let's do
Da
that.
da!
Who are you? Every
Yeah.
last maiden to attend the royal ball.
Wow, how exciting.
How exciting for Cindy. But her stepmother didn't want her to attend. Why is that?
She probably could see how beautiful this young Ella was, is. Keine Ahnung.
Yeah, but that's a good question. Like, why did she have something? Why was she so against Ella? Like, surely she would have had no reason. Ella wasn't entitled to it, or was she entitled? Should the father's riches have actually gone to Ella, and they went to? I don't think so. I don't think
That
so.
gets too far off the story. Do we have to discuss this now? I don't even think about it. Her motives are, I don't know. Do we have to know her motives to
Well,
tell the
I mean,
story?
no. Well, we're telling an old story. It is a question to raise. Like, why did she not want Ella to go to the ball? Like
She
a.
didn't want Ella from the beginning. She probably didn't want Ella to be there. Maybe she was jealous in the beginning.
Well, anyways, Ella wasn't allowed to go to the ball. The mother kept sort of promising, oh, yes, you know, if you do this and this and do this and this, then you can come to the ball. And then it just never happened because Ella never actually got all of her work done.
We need to practice our storytelling, I believe.
No,
so,
this is a story for adults, you know.
Okay,
you have to have a
so,
rhyme and reason.
So she bought lovely dresses for her two daughters, and Cinderella, Ella had to sew stuff on, had to prepare the dresses and had to help to, and she saw how the girls got ready for the ball and she was not invited.
No, that's right. And then she cried and cried. And cried
30
until
hours on a plane.
Until her hanky was full. She cried and she cried. And she thought, I wanted to go to the ball with my sisters. And she then eventually she ran out into the pumpkin patch for some reason. We don't know why. I think she just wanted a change of scenery. So she left the kitchen and she went into the pumpkin patch to go there and cry some more. And then all of a sudden, who appeared? Someone appeared.
A fairy grandmother, wasn't it?
Yeah, the fairy godmother.
Fairy godmother, keine Ahnung, yeah.
Now, how, where, you know, and this character is interesting because this character just sort of appears out of nowhere. Like, really just appears out of nowhere. She's saying that she's a godmother, so she must have been around at the time of birth. But this is the first time any character in the whole story has known anything about this fairy godmother, but suddenly she's appearing there. And she's saying, oh, why are you crying? Why are you crying? I'm going to a ball. I'm going to a ball to have a dance off. Why aren't you going? And then Cinderella says, "Fuck off."
They wouldn't let me go. I don't have a dress. I'm full of ashes, and I have a lot of work to do. So anyway, the stepmother before then the good mother. Wasn't that when everybody was away that she was crying?
Oh yeah, they'd all left. Like they're literally out the door.
And the
sort
stepmother
of
left
thinking,
her
shit.
Peas and beans to on the floor. She threw peas and beans on the floor.
Oh, yeah, well,
and said you have to separate the beans and the peas from each other.
Oh, did she?
And then Cinderella opened the window, and her doves came flying in.
I don't know which version. I don't know what
That's
version.
That's a very
you read,
old
but...
ancient version. F-U-C-K Walt Disney. I'm sorry, I must say this right now. Because the old version is very beautiful and Walt Disney got the crap out of Cinderella. He ruined the whole story, basically.
Well, so we've got this. Okay, so she's finished sorting out the peas and the beans. She just doesn't want to do that anymore. She wants
so the doves
to
took over. She left the doves in and they separated the peas and the beans for her.
Right.
Because she has treated the doves kindly all the way through. That's what I'm saying.
Okay, so she got outside help. She outsourced
yes.
her work. She smartly got the doves to come in and she outsourced to those doves to separate them, but it still didn't help her any because she still couldn't go to the
still
ball.
Still didn't get her address
no,
for the ball.
No, so she got a little bit of help there to separate peas
but
and
she
beans.
But she was free to go then because the work was finished. That was the first point. She was free to go. And then the fairy godmother appeared and waved her wand, her magic wand, and she had a beautiful dress suddenly. Wasn't that?
Well, something along those lines, but, you know, no one's ever seen this woman before who comes in claiming, I'm your fairy godmother. No one has ever seen her before, and she says, but I'm going to come here and I'm going to transform you, and everyone's just okay with that. Yeah, okay. Yeah, sure, whatever.
Go ahead.
Yeah, go ahead.
Transform me.
Yeah, no
here
worries.
I am.
Yep, yeah, go ahead. So anyway, she does indeed magically get a dress, and it's a beautiful dress. Actually, I think it was the prettiest dress at the ball. So the fairy godmother gave her the most beautiful dress at the ball, but she couldn't get there because obviously the castle is like 30 hours travel away, you know.
Changed a pumpkin into a beautiful coach.
So that's right, she changed a pumpkin into, you have to come up with that sort of creativity, you know. Not everyone has that.
And she changed four mice into the coach guards.
Hmm.
And she changed, I don't know, the dog
into the coachman. Coachman, yeah.
Yes. Yes, something like that. And then off she went. But she said one, what's it called in English?
I don't know. What are you trying to say?
Die Sache hat einen Haken.
But there was one twist. It had a catch.
It had a catch.
All these promises and all these niceties had a catch, as they always do.
Yes, it seems. So it seems. Yes, and so before midnight, Cinderella had to leave the ball because everything was changing back to normal.
Yeah, so at midnight, at the stroke of midnight, when the town clock struck midnight, her carriage would be a pumpkin again, her coachman would be a dog, and the horses would all be mice, and she'd be
and
in
the dress
tattered rags.
Would be her dress that was dust and ashes.
That's right.
And she would have been... exactly. So off she went.
Yeah, you know what I realize, you know? When the fairy godmother gave her that nice dress, she never at any point had a shower. Not at any point did she actually have a shower, but who cares? They all stunk. All right, keep going.
Not everybody stinks. Just don't worry so much. I mean, not everybody's...
Back, this is going back okay. 500-600 years. They didn't shower every
yes.
day. They didn't shower at all.
They had a wash. And I suppose that means they had clear food. They don't eat all this chemical-produced food.
Yeah, that's a good point. So they probably wouldn't have stunken so much anyway
yes.
because they were all eating... There was nothing except natural food to eat. You know, and very, very little sugar
yeah.
for most people.
Yeah, so yeah. They probably had a natural... No,
so they
whatever.
Didn't stink.
Anyhow.
They just didn't stink that much. Yeah, good point.
No,
that's
exactly,
a good point.
Exactly.
Yeah.
The environment was much healthier than it is now.
Mm.
But we are hard in... We are hard... Hardcore ladies anyway. Sometimes we can be, if it has to be. So off she went to the ball, to the castle.
Smelly, but looking good, but smelly. Yep.
She smelled like a rose, like a fragrance of a beautiful rose. I've got
until,
roses
until
in my...
Until midnight, and then she'd go back to stinking.
stop it.
Stinking
cut it
like
out,
kitchen
you
grease.
Unromantic woman, you.
Okay.
Really. Okay, I tried to dive into... Asher put it story. So off she went, and the castle was shining with candlelight. She listened to beautiful music that came out of the open windows, and she saw the people in the castle dancing. And she entered in, and when she entered into the ballroom, already when she entered in, all the servants were looking at her because they were like astonished by her beauty. What a beauty is entering this castle. Mm. And she was an unknown princess. And as soon as she entered the ballroom...
Well, she wasn't. They thought she was because of her dress. Just because of the way
yes.
she was dressed, they thought
she
must
like
come from
princess
money.
From far away.
Yes.
And
far away
she,
in the kitchen.
When the prince recognized her immediately, and he was astonished.
Didn't. How could he
huh?
recognize the kitchen maid?
Because she was an unknown princess when she entered the ballroom, and he sensed when she entered
oh,
the ballroom.
Sensed,
the,
sensed
wait,
that
wait,
she was
wait,
special.
Wait, wait! This is a very magical moment. When she entered the ballroom, the whole ballroom, the whole atmosphere was transformed because this humble, beautiful. Princess Ella ballroom, and he caught something of her fragrance because he wasn't a stupid blind. So he recognized, he saw her, and he was
well, it was
immediately...
hard to miss. Like, she came, what describe a little bit, what did her dress look like?
No, it was not about a dress, it was something about
no,
her
it
whole
was.
Appearance.
It was the dress, and she
because,
had an aura.
No, because,
she had
no,
an aura.
We had princesses all over the ballroom. All dressed up to kill, okay? But this beautiful young Ella, she had experienced a life full of tragedy, of harsh words. I don't know if her stepmother slapped her, but she sticks.
Probably.
She stuck to her, you know, to the way she was, and she was kind to everyone. And she was different. She stuck out to her the way she was, the
and
way
you,
she
you
appeared.
You could just tell. You could look at her and you could tell.
So he was
yeah.
amazed by her appearance, and left. I don't know if he was dancing with somebody. He left his place and
stop that. Fuck you. I'm going over there.
F-U-C-K we don't use in we try not to use. I'm sorry.
Okay.
I have to apologize
okay.
for
okay.
me as well. I'm sorry. So he went towards her, and the music stopped. Everybody stopped, and because she entered the room, It was like Zeitlupe. This
Time,
moment,
like a slow motion.
slow motion. At
Yeah.
that moment, it was like a slow motion. Everything stopped for seconds, and he moved towards her because he was astonished by her appearance. Because he was like thinking all the way through, like, oh my goodness, my parents, what have you done inviting all those girls I'm not interested in?
So
Leave me alone.
it wasn't him, it was his parents that kept inviting that they invited all the
Yes.
eligible young
He wasn't ready
maidens.
for such a big move, you know? He wasn't really ready. He was still this big boy in a man's body,
He was
not growing up, not ready for
emotionally
commitment.
retarded.
Yeah, completely. That's what they all are until they meet the right one. High five! Bam! Now we are getting into the story.
So,
All
okay, so
right,
she.
you must make me probably two or three parts out of our
No,
podcast here. It's
it's a
really
first episode special anyway.
okay. So
So he sees,
we
okay.
take a we take
So
time.
just to recap now, so he's dancing with someone and he thinks, "Nah, actually, nah."
No, he was not.
Then oh, he wasn't dancing. Okay. He was just sitting by the bar having a beer or
Yes,
something.
but no, he was just sitting near the throne of his father, rolling
Being
his
very
eyes and
bored, like,
hoping that his
oh.
ball is soon over. But suddenly, you know, when the music stopped and he moved towards this girl, this young lady, and then he turned around and recognized the music wasn't playing. He was like, "Hey, music!" You know, he was like, "Play music!"
So
And he
he
went
clicked his
to,
fingers
and
and
then the
said,
music went on.
continue.
What kind of music should we choose for this specific moment? My confession from Josh Groban, you know this one?
No,
I have been
but I'll
blind without you.
no, but I'll listen to it. I'll play it in the end credits. So what is it called?
Oh.
My confession, is it? My confession.
Yes, but I sent you the special version. I mean, it's a very special. Wait, I sent you this. This is my favorite.
It's not a
I've
Christian
shared it
song,
on
is it?
Facebook
It's not a
because
Christian
it's so.
song. They don't play Christian songs at the ball.
This is just my confession to his beloved. Calm down. They made it up with Christian pictures, but he is the lyrics are completely. He's in love with a woman. It's my confession. It's his
No,
confession to his beloved.
okay. No, I've got the perfect song. Hang on a second.
Oh no! What do you come up with now?
Just hang on.
I sent you my
Calm
confession on
yourself.
yes. I sent you this anyway. Oh, what is she doing now? What do you make out of our fairy tale? Okay. This is Ingrid, not Walt Disney. Calm yourself down.
Oh, damn, what is that song? Yes, Lady in Red by Christa Berg. Let's,
No. Now you
because she had
ruined
a
it.
red dress on.
Now
Yeah,
you ruined
no, I
it.
haven't. Let's,
I knew it.
let
I knew
We'll
it.
play, we'll,
Lady
no,
in Red.
Lady in Red. It's a
Okay, she was wearing
classic.
a red ball
Yes,
dress?
in our
Really?
dress, yes. In our
Okay.
story, the dress was red. Yes, and it was sparkly,
Okay.
like a diamond. So, she comes
Okay.
in wearing this red dress, and
You
it's a
have to
big
make
poofy ball
compromises
gown.
in life.
You have to make
Right.
compromises, and
Okay.
at
Yes.
this very moment, he clicked his fingers, and somehow Lady in Red by Christa Berg was
Sugar,
playing,
really?
and yeah, absolutely. And so
There you
they just
go.
hit the dance floor and they just hit it
My
off.
confession.
They hit it
Listen
off.
to my confession and then we discuss this choice later,
Okay,
okay?
well, I can play both at the end of the podcast and we'll let the
Yes,
listeners
please
decide.
do.
Let's let the listeners decide which song was playing at the ball, whether it was My Confession by Josh
Gorban, I sent it on Messenger already. You've got it. You've
Gore.
got it
Oh, I
already.
can't check now. So, whether it was My Confession by Josh Groban or Christa Berg, Lady in Red, we'll let them decide.
Oh, you have your own music for this. We like to get back to us and recommend your choice of music. That would be nice, wouldn't it?
No,
What
it was
everybody's
Lady in
romantic
Red.
choice? Okay. Oh no! How boring.
Don't let people fiddle with our story. So it was Lady in Red by
Okay.
Christa Berg. End of story.
Never forget a lady in red. Okay. Oh, okay, Christopher. Oh, well, right. Okay.
Right, and
Yes.
then what happened? So they started dancing, and they had a few. They were drinking the whole time, let's be honest.
Was no drink involved. She was sober.
Hang on a second.
sober.
He was just sitting at the bar having a beer when she walked in. Of course they were drinking.
There's a beer breath. I wouldn't even dance with this man
Well, you
if I were
wouldn't, but we're
Ella.
talking
Okay,
about
I'm not
Ella.
Ella.
We're talking
But
about
okay,
Ella, okay?
her nose was a bit stiff by the time she because she smelled so many, she had to breathe in too many ashes from cleaning the stove, so she didn't really smell his breath.
Her nose didn't work that
So yeah, she stiffened her nose right through the years because she couldn't stand the smell of her stepmother and her two sisters. And he came along a little slight tipsy with his
He was
beer
already
breath
he
and was
was
like,
already a bit tipsy by the time she
"Hello,
walked in.
honey, where are
Yep.
you coming from, sweetie pie? I
And she...
haven't seen you around
And let's be honest, she got bloody excited. She
Yes,
got really excited
his breath
that
smell was like a like what is it called? Ingredients for
barley.
no, what's it called? What's it called?
I don't know what he's talking about. Speak, woman.
Well, yeah, mir fällt noch nicht mehr der deutsche Name ein.
She
Ist
speaks
egal,
in
ich komme
German
noch
when she
drauf.
gets nervous.
Anyway, she was so astonished
Yes,
because the
by this
prince
beer
came
breath.
walking towards
Well,
her.
sort of
The
jaywalking.
great
By that
prince
time,
comes
he was sort of
walking
torkling
down
a
to
little
the
bit.
maiden, to Ella. She was really, "Oh my God, he's coming towards me." Ah!
I know,
Yes.
I know. And then the
Boom,
let's
boom,
play.
boom, heartbeat.
Yeah, I know, I know. She couldn't even breathe. She was just that
She
amazed.
almost
She didn't know
fainted
what to
because
do. Didn't
he
know what to
stood in
do.
front of her. But when he opened his mouth and she, no, she couldn't smell. We had that. So what is
Her nose was clogged with ashes. So anyway.
Die hat eine Klaube an der Nase gehabt. Nein, Spaß.
No,
Was
no,
sagt
no,
er zu
no, no.
ihr?
He says, can I have this dance with you?" And she says,
Wow.
"Absolutely." And
Wow.
she had no idea how to dance. Let's face it, because she'd never had dancing lessons. She'd been
She
in
was
the kitchen all of her life.
practicing with her broomstick in the kitchen. Don't be silly.
Oh.
She knew how to dance. Everybody knows how to dance. Really?
Well,
She knew
let's
how
just
to.
say.
She was dancing with her broomstick in the kitchen. She was a lovely, great dancer. But this prince guy always skipped dancing lessons, and he stepped on her feet while they were dancing.
Yeah, absolutely. Like her feet was sore. Sore. After a
He
few
was
hours.
like
They're
an
bloody sore.
elephant with her.
Yes,
No, no, no. No,
I could tell you stories. But anyway. So anyway, they danced and danced and danced, and they had a wonderful
around
time.
in circles. The music was wonderful. Christa Berg was over, so the next music came on. Then came Josh Groban,
And then
and she melted away because her ears were clear. Her nose was stiff, and her ears were clear. And they were looking into each other's eyes. Wow, what a guy. What has he got, brown or blue eyes? I fancy brown eyes.
They're a sort of mix between blue and brown.
Okay, they changed in between. He's got
They
those
changed.
colored.
They changed with his personality, so we don't talk
No,
about it
no
much,
way.
but this prince had split personality syndrome. So they would change intermittently every half an hour or so. The color would change between blue and brown.
Die Linsen, die man künstlich
Lenses, yeah,
reinsetzen
so
kann.
colorful lenses. I mean,
Colorful lenses. He swapped them in between. I don't know which color of eyes you like. Sorry for my breath. Oh, I can't smell you anywhere, darling, because my nose is
it's
stiff.
full of
So I
ashes.
don't mind the color of your eyes either. But
Yep.
my ears are very good, and I'm not the smartest either. So go ahead.
I can cook well. And I clean all right too. I've got lots of cleaning experience.
Oh, ich schmeiß
Got lots of cleaning experience, and I can cook all right, and I get along well with
But
birds.
darling, if you're with me, you don't have to cook because I'm the prince, and for me, they cook every day.
And to be honest, you don't need to be that smart either. As you
All I
know,
need is a pretty woman I can make love to day and night.
pretty
Isn't that
much,
the
that's pretty much what he said. Yeah, I think he hit the nail on the head.
Because he was a prince, he didn't have to work 25/7. all day
25/7
long.
he didn't
Oh.
yeah definitely not 24/7, and didn't even have to work
20,
25, so
24/7, you.
yeah.
And she was really, is that an offer of whatever? I don't get it. What do you want? So they were dancing, and she was like,
She didn't get it. Like, she didn't get the no. I mean, this is to be fair, like, this is the first time a guy had approached her in her whole life. So
Yes,
she didn't really
true.
get it. She didn't know exactly what he wanted, you know.
Yes. So
She was a little bit
and he
super
didn't know.
attached.
He spoke to jerks all his life, and he didn't know how to articulate himself because he never really showed his feelings to anybody till that moment. So he didn't really know how to approach
No. Yeah,
properly.
that's right. So there was a bit of a problem, you know, from his side. He didn't know how to approach someone, and
That's why you
she
have to
didn't.
listen to Josh Corbett, my
And
confession.
she wasn't the brightest. She had no experience. She was a bit naive, you know. So
Yes.
she didn't know what he wanted, what he was trying to say. Like, speak,
And he
boy,
was
speak.
saying,
And it
"Oh,
wasn't
I
working.
must send. Wait. Forget the version I sent you, because there is this version, Josh Gordon, My Confession, with Pride and Prejudice from the movie Pride and Prejudice pictures in the background, with Keira Knightley, and the actor is another gorgeous man, and they both together, they play so well together, and then My Confession in the background, very
I'm not a
nice."
huge fan of Keira Knightley.
Me neither, but that is just the song, and the plays are quite nice. Nice mate.
Yeah, okay. All right.
Okay, I'm not a great fan of her too, but there. But that doesn't matter really. It's not about fan being. It's not about Kira. It's about Ella.
Yes, it's about Ella.
Back
So
to Ella.
let's make it about Ella. This is about
Yeah.
Ella.
So they danced, and suddenly, dong. Dong, the clock stroke, and Ella counted, and she realized that was the clock stroke 12. So she
Struck midnight.
struck, thank you, struck. So she turned around, she left him completely in the middle of the ballroom, standing there by himself. She ran away like crazy,
And
ran down the
he's
stairs.
the prince is just thinking, what the beep?
What is going on here?
What did I just do? Did I just say something?
I forgot to say something. That's the problem.
Maybe I didn't say enough. Whoops. She's running away. Why?
Yeah, he couldn't articulate himself.
Oh
That's what
well.
happened. Then you run away because you can't wait lifelong time till the guy articulates himself. Really, I'm growing old, getting gray, and the guy hasn't articulated
Well, yeah,
himself.
but that point, Ella had gone completely grey. That's how long they'd been dancing, and he hadn't said anything.
No, Ella, it was just the same day the clock stroke
Struck.
struck, and she ran off. And on the stairs, nothing. No, she ran off. Actually, in the original, she was three times at the ball. All right, and because she always ran away, die haben Teer auf die Treppe gemacht, damit
They
sie den
put tar
Schuh
on
von
it.
ihr kriegen.
So you're saying
Yes.
in the original version she was actually
Yes.
at a ball 3 times, and in the last
Yes.
time she was there, they put tar on the stairs to stop her
Yes.
from running.
So I tell you, I tell you, as a little girl, right? I was feeling like a step girl. I have a sister, and my father was away studying, and my mom and my sister were always together, and I was by myself. And I discovered the wonderful fantasy world of books. And my father always came back with books. And the first book I real I rec I remember he gave to me was the original story of Aschenputtel, and I was diving into the story, and I was Aschenputtel myself, so that's why I remember all the bits and pieces of it. But the prince hasn't really come. I missed that part. I'm still waiting for the prince, but I'm not Cinderella anymore, so we skip that part. But that's why I know the story so well, mit dem Teer auf der Treppe, with the tar on the stairs.
Yeah.
And when she ran off, she lost the shoe. That's why the sh she lost the, she didn't
Well,
lost the shoe by
because it
accident.
stuck to the tar.
Exactly,
Well, there you go.
a very
There you
important
go.
point.
That's
There you
what Disney
go.
didn't tell you. It stuck to the tar.
I got the book in the 70s, so they've been close to the original. Praise God for this one, really. Thank you, Lord. I really love the originals.
Yeah.
You can't compare them with anything. So
Oh,
anyway,
well,
and then they
here's a
had.
question. Here's a question for you. From which country did the original story of Cinderella actually originate?
Brüder Grimm?
No,
Deutschland?
no,
No?
it didn't come from Germany. It was a French fairy tale.
Oh,
I think
wow.
The guy's name was Pierrot, actually.
Wasn't that Gebrüder Grimm?
No, it was a French guy. French guy
really?
Took the original notation of the story.
So we could put the whole placing setting to Versailles.
This all happened in Versailles. That's right.
Wow. I've once slept in Versailles in the garden. I tell you this story another time. I was
sleeping for a night in
Versailles. When I was going to Spain, I tell you this story another time.
Please.
I was sleeping in Versailles gardens. Have you ever done this? I did.
No, I haven't actually. No.
I did. Yes, I did. Ha ha. Da, 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 da.
Anyway, so she loses her shoe.
Back to Ella.
So she loses her shoe, and she's making a run for it. And this time she's late, because
and
the
has
clock
run
is already,
home.
Has already well, it's already struck 8. So she's got another 4 strokes to go. But this time,
but
the
she had
prince
to run
is
home
following
because
her.
Everything was already changing. So she had to run home in a haste, because the coach was already a pumpkin.
That was
everything
gone.
Was already no.
Yeah, that was
it was
all
gone.
Gone.
So she had to really run home to be there before her stepmother.
And that was
came
a long.
Back.
It was a long run.
Yeah,
a bloody long run.
Okay, I don't know. Maybe the pumpkin wasn't changed and the horse was still the horse. So
well, let's say we got halfway. She got halfway home and then it changed.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah.
Okay.
So
and then she cried because she thought that was the last time. And I think that was the third
no,
time
she
was
didn't.
The last time that she could
in
go
a,
to
in
the
a,
ball.
In the original, she didn't cry. Why should she cry? She had
because
just...
this isn't the original. This is the story that we're making up. So now she's crying.
Ah, all right.
She's crying
crying.
For 14
okay.
hours straight, and her bloody hanky is as
all
wet
right,
as
yes.
a bucket.
Yeah. So and back into her old dress and crying, and the tissue is soaked full of tears.
And snot. And snot. It's
and
realistic.
Snot.
It's a realistic
plenty of snot,
story.
Which made
tears
her nose
snot.
Free to smell again.
It was all the ash came out of it. And she thought,
yes,
I never
and
smelled
she
that.
She suddenly
that
could
good.
Realize the smell of roses
and
the smell
and
of fresh
smell
air.
Of
and
that's right.
And she liked her own smell. It was a bit sweaty,
she
but
liked
okay.
her own smell.
Yeah,
she felt
because she was
in
at peace
stench.
With herself.
Yeah.
She was like, it's all right, it's me.
It's not too bad. I can go another few months. Before I have to shower again, that's okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, the prince didn't care. He thought it was all right. He wasn't too bothered. Anyway, so that was the last ball, and that was the last time that she saw the prince. So what happened next? The prince didn't give up so easily.
No,
he
they
wasn't,
found the shoe.
He wasn't as emotionally deranged as we thought he was.
So he could articulate that he is searching for the woman he... Did he fell in love that night?
No, I think
I don't
he fell
know.
In love the first night, and then he just wanted to keep seeing her.
Yeah.
So he kept having these balls just to,
yeah,
to
that's,
see
that's
her
true,
again.
Yeah, that's true, actually. Yes, yes,
yeah.
yes.
Yeah.
I must read the original again. It's worthwhile reading again. I was reading it as a kid on and on and on and on and on, diving in. I didn't get
so
out
anyway,
of that story.
And so this time he thought, we're not having another ball, but she keeps running off on me. So... So she went to her father, he went to his father, and he articulated as best he could, shoe, girl, missing, must find girl, shoe belongs to girl. And so what he decided to do was arrange for a search party. And this was the ultimate French medieval search party. And all they had was this one shoe. And interestingly, there was no, they all had different foot sizes back then in medieval France, or either that or there really that weren't that many people. So he'd already somehow he'd worked out that she was a local girl. She wasn't actually a princess at all. She was a local girl that just had very good manners. And so he took this one shoe that could only fit her for some reason, no one else.
She had very tiny, tiny,
exceptionally
feet.
Tiny.
Yeah.
Like
yes.
Chinese bound feet.
Yeah, that was
tiny,
my thinking.
Bloody
like, yeah?
tiny they were. Anyway, so he goes around and he sends these messages with this shoe, with this glass. Was it glass? Was it a glass shoe?
Yeah, but that's I who can dance in glass shoes? Come on.
Well, they were pretty sturdy glass. They were,
I mean,
it was
with a glass
shoe.
Shoe is not entire. Come on.
All right,
yeah.
So we won't make a glass. We'll say they were diamond shoes because you can't break diamonds. They were diamond shoes.
Pearls, a shoe with nice pearls on it, a beautiful, perfect, nice dancing shoe.
Okay, it just looked nice. It just looked nice. So it was a really nice shoe with
I
pearls on
must
it.
show you a picture of a shoe I got out of big frustration I had a few weeks ago. I bought myself a very nice pair of shoes.
That you'll never wear because you'll.
I wear them already
Oh,
and they look
really?
amazing. I have them on my Facebook cover, red shoes. You must have a look.
All right, I'll have a look. Lady in red. Anyway, so then,
Is
sing
dancing
with
with
me.
me. I
Or she
never
was.
forget
And now we
to
have to find
sing
her.
with.
So he searches the whole kingdom, and every night the messengers come back with terrible news. We have not found this girl. We have not been able to find this girl. We've looked in every duchy, looked in every baron's house. We have looked in every nobleman's house that we could think of. And this
And then
girl,
they
her.
came to the house of this stepmother, and the stepmother called her two daughters. And because the daughters' feet didn't fit into that tiny
Because they
shoe,
had massive feet.
die haben Fe von Ferse was abgeschnitten, damit die in den Schuh reinpasst. Und dann,
Ja.
das musst du jetzt übersetzen. Und dann haben die Tauben ge gegurrt, rucke die Gu, da ist Blut im Schuh. Er
So.
führt die falsche Braut heim. So that's the true story.
So I've just been tasked with translating that. So what happened in the original was that the and this is true. This is absolutely true. What happened in the original story was that the two stepsisters who had these massive feet, obviously much much bigger than Cinderella's little Chinese bound feet, they actually cut off their heels, the heel of their foot, to be able to fit into the shoe. And they were obviously they were spitting blood everywhere. The blood was pissing, but no one seemed to notice.
Just
For
a
some
little
reason,
blood.
no one. A little bit of blood is normal, and
And
everyone.
nobody recognized, that's why the doves were saying this, rucka-de-goo,
Yeah, I'm
there's blood
getting to
in the
that.
shoe.
I'm getting to that. So anyway,
Okay.
so there's blood pissing everywhere, but
Oh, come on,
the
woman.
high officials, they don't seem to notice. No one notices that there's the fill blood is, the shoe is filling up with blood. And actually, it's the doves who come into the house and they start cooing, and they're cooing, rookity coo, look at you. There's blood spilling everywhere in the shoe.
He's leading the wrong bride home. That's
Yes,
what they
he's taking the
said.
wrong bride home. And then suddenly the officials say, "My God, yes, you're right. Look, there is blood everywhere. How could we have not have seen this?" And so they realized, "Yes, you're right, birds."
Get my shoe back. Go off, woman. So he took the shoe back, but because the
But by
shoe was
now it
full
was
of
full of
blood,
blood, yeah.
and he found a tissue on the ground full with snot and wet. He took that tissue
It was
and
a
quick
hanky.
cleaned the hanky.
It was a
That
hanky.
full sniffed hanky she left on the ground.
She dropped it. Fell out of a bra.
Yes, he took that hanky into his hands, didn't realizing that there was snot and tears from her in it.
He said, you
To
know,
clean, he
in
wiped the
German,
blood off the shoe.
ein bisschen Spucke macht alles wieder gut. A little bit of
Genau.
spit fixes everything.
Right, exactly. So then he said, here must be another one in the house. So they
Somehow. So
insisted, they
how he came up
insisted.
with that, how on earth he actually worked that out. I mean, you're talking about a guy who sees blood, a pool of blood building on the floor and doesn't notice, but from a snotty hanky, somehow he's put two and two together, which somehow, and thought,
Very
yes,
unusual for a
the
man.
woman
No,
with
no, no,
those
no, I haven't
Chinese
said
bound
that.
feet must be in
Yes.
this house. I don't know how he
Well,
worked that out, but anyway.
I think he did ask, are you sure there is no one else living here? And then finally the truth appeared. Oh, yes, there is Ella in a blah, 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 a
Who
servant
said that?
probably.
Who said that?
A servant, a
What
servant.
servant? Ella was the only servant.
No, they had more servants than just Ella.
Did they?
Yes, they did.
Okay, all right. So a
But
servant comes along.
I don't know the original. But anyhow, make up whatever.
So, okay, we'll just make up on our story to make it plausible. So the official is going back out of the house with the bloody shoe and thinking, well, that was our last call. The shoe is bloody ruined now. Look at it. Freaking red. Used to be white. It's red now. It looks like a tampon. He's walking out of the house. Don't look at me like that. And then he
Red, red, red shoes, I would have said, but okay, white
No, they
shoes,
were
red dress.
white. Pearls are white. You told me that. Pearls on them. So
Okay.
he's walking out of the house. He and then he hears like a sniffle, like, and then And he turns around and he thinks, what the hell was I? And he turns around
yeah.
and from the high, in the fourth story window, high up from the attic, he can see a girl sitting there with a hanky, crying like the billy-o, and snotting into the handkerchief. And he thinks, hang on a minute. And he walks back into the house and he says to the stepmother, who actually didn't want to let him back in, but he's gotten in anyway, and he says, well, who's that girl up in the fourth story in the attic window? And then she says, no, not anybody. That's just the ash, that's the cinder maid. That's just the cinder maid. She's not important. And then he says, I must see her. No, no, you can't. She's having a poo. She's having a poo. She can't be disturbed right now.
Oh, come on, woman. Oh. That is not nice. All right, you can't see her now. I'm not, you know, she had to insist, but just leave that toilet talk out of the story.
You don't
one
appreciate
one of my favorite
talk?
Stories, please. Please.
All right. Okay. Okay.
The handkerchief is not, and tears is accepted, of course.
Okay, and then, okay, so he goes back in and says, I must see this woman because this hanky that I have just cleaned the or tried to clean the shoe with is the same hanky that I just saw the girl in the fourth story blowing her nose with again. I have to go up there. So reluctantly, because, you know, he was a high official, she couldn't just say no forever. So he goes all the way back up to the fourth story, and then he says, Madam, or Mademoiselle, would you like to try on this shoe? And she says, yes, please. You know, and so she tries on the shoe.
And she got out the second one.
And it fits. It fitted. And then she said, voila. Voila, yeah. Monsieur. Two shoes. Deux. Hang on. Un, deux shoes.
Un, deux, trois. Yeah, deux.
Deux shoes, s'il vous plaît.
Deux shoes.
Deux shoes, s'il vous plaît. And because she had the second shoe, he knew that this must be the right girl. And it was as easy as that. And then he took her back to the castle.
Mm.
And then the prince finds out that she's actually a cinder maid. She's not a foreign-born noblewoman. She's not a local noblewoman. She's not anything except a cinder maid. So what does he say? You tell us the reaction.
Je t'aime?
Je t'aime. It doesn't matter, je t'aime.
Okay.
Je t'aime. So it was je t'aime from the moment he re-saw
je
her.
Je t'aime.
Even as a cinder maid, he didn't care. He did not
Mi
care.
Mi amore.
No, je t'aime. That's Italian or something.
Okay,
je
ich habe ich weiß das.
Is French. Je t'aime. Mm.
Ich kann kein.
And then he said je m'appelle Prince. And
what that heißt? I'm the prince. Yeah?
No, my name's Prince.
Ah, okay. Je m'appelle Prince.
Je t'aime, and I love you. You're my love.
And then he sang her the song from Prince. Don't have to be beautiful to turn me on.
Oh,
just
she
kiss.
Was. She was.
Kiss,
she was.
Yes, but he sings the song
that.
From. He sings the song from Prince to comfort her in a way of, however you are, all I want from you is a kiss.
Oh, I thought she started singing because he got nervous.
Yeah, but that's a lovely song, isn't it? Isn't that a great song from Prince?
Oh, she's a cinder maid. Yes, it is a good song.
I really fancy that song. It's a great one. So he was like, and so off they went, laughing and kissing and having fun and lived heavy,
well,
heavy,
no.
happy after.
No, hang on a second. They didn't kiss until they got married. Yeah.
That's really?
That's the proper way to do things.
Yes, oh, no.
Yes.
You cannot marry anyone you don't know how, if he's, without a kiss, marrying. Well, okay.
You know, Bianca, this is a bit rich coming from you.
Is that from the 1100s? What time did they make that story
this,
up?
This story actually comes from the 1300s.
Really?
The
14th
century.
That old.
So we'll just
and
say
they, in that story they in this story they don't even kiss. We just put it in.
We just put it in. Put it straight in.
Yeah.
What the hell? No.
Well, they didn't kiss in that story altogether. They just got married.
Yeah, well, they did because, let's face it, I mean, they'd known each other for quite some time by then. Yeah,
three
no.
balls, three
Balls,
balls
three
for
balls
1 or 2 hours makes you known the person for eternity. Well,
No, well, there was no sex before marriage, so they had to get married pretty quickly. No, that's the way it was. So they got married pretty quickly, and then the they
They
well.
figured they can dance together quite well without stepping on each other's feet
Well,
and
they took dancing
reckoned.
lessons. They learned. They took some proper dancing lessons, and then
Okay.
they both learned how to dance properly. And the evil stepmother, what happened to her?
Oh, she got punishment.
What did she do? What
I
happened?
don't know. I don't know if she got. I don't want to go back to her, really. They left happily ever after and.
Well, see, that's what Cinderella said. That's exactly what Cinderella, she said, oh, you know what? I really don't want to go back to her. So that's why she stayed in the palace forever. And eventually the trouble caught up with the evil stepmother, and she became a kitchen scullery maid in the palace.
Kitchen scullery maid, who? The stepmother?
Yeah.
No. Kitchen scullery maid in. What is
In the
that?
palace in Versailles, she became the
No!
yes.
No way! Not near her. Their ways separated. Their ways completely separated. Really?
Well, okay. Well, so what happened to her? You tell me. What happened to her?
I don't care. I couldn't care less, really. I'm happy for Cinderella. I don't care about the
Well,
stepmother and her two
sorry
daughters.
guys, we have a really shit ending to the story because no one cares about what
Why
happened to
should ending?
the
The, all
stepmother.
that matters was that Ella and the prince have each other, and you want a happy ending for the stepmother? I don't really think about
No,
that.
but there has to
No.
be, we have to know what happens to the characters. We know what happens to Cinderella, we know what happens to the prince.
So you want that all the characters are looked at and that they have all a proper ending.
Yes.
Okay, I figure. I tell you, I'm a bit slow in that. I don't know.
Well, that's what I'm saying. She became a kitchen scullery maid in the palace.
Okay, if you want.
Yeah, and she lived there until the day she fell into an oven and died. The end.
Okay, and the two sisters?
Well,
They
they.
haven't. They married. They married two of the servants and made their life hell. No, the other way around. The servants turned the two stepsisters into lovely women. They yielded to the servants and lived happy ever after.
In a perfect world. In a perfect world.
Yeah, is that it? I don't know. I'm not very. I don't know.
What could we do with the evil stepsisters? They became street sweepers. Let's say they became.
No,
Yeah, back in the day
that
when you only
yeah.
had a broom. Yeah,
Okay,
when you only had a
okay.
broom and they were sent to the city of Paris and they had to spend their nights and their days sweeping the streets. And there was nasty, bless you, and there was nasty things on those streets.
For the
Nasty.
rest of their lives, they had
Rest of their lives.
no way to repent altogether. Oh, the poor things.
Well,
Really?
things were pretty gruesome back then. They were lucky that they got away with their lives. You know?
Wow,
Yeah.
very harsh.
Yeah. Well, Cinderella was pretty pissed. You know, she was pretty pissed about all that.
No, that was not her character. That's besides, she was a nice young good-hearted girl. So she wasn't pissed or angry, or she was one of those perfect people who don't really exist.
All right, well, let's say that the prince was pretty angry because he was a little bit cantankerous. He
Yes,
could
because
be cantankerous.
they treated
Yeah.
his wife bad, so
Yeah.
he punished them with like giving them to work in the kitchen as a helper for the stepmother. And because the stepmother was stressed because she had a lot of work to do, she was harsh to her own daughters eventually. Eventually, she took on responsibility to raise her daughters into normal women who grab a spoon and do the dishes and clean the floor and clean the windows. And so once in a while, they had a row together in the kitchen and they could hear it in a front yard, but
In the front yard of
nobody
Versailles.
really
You could
cared.
still hear it. It was so loud you could hear
Yeah,
it.
but the kitchens were in the basement. In Nordstrom, the castle, you have the kitchen down there, you remember?
Yeah, like yeah, in Marienburg. That's Marine
Yeah,
Walk.
so when they had the row, they closed the window so nobody could hear them fighting. Exactly. And that was their life.
Yeah.
But the stepmother was a miserable cook, so the prince had to abandon her. Say, no, your cooking is really not good. So he gave her a little rent and left her and the daughter somewhere in the countryside, and they carried on with life.
Yeah.
Tried to do good work among the poorest.
That's right. And eventually
as a punishment.
Eventually Cinderella forgot about them, and so did the prince, and they went on to have 15 children, and everyone was happy. And
yeah, with 15 children. Wow.
Yeah, well, that was a job. You know, that,
yeah,
that,
and he ruled the country, and he occupied other countries because the 15 children all need their own kingdom, and
he wanted to get away from them. He wanted to get away from them, so he went and conquered other countries, and she was left at home making children. And every year or so he would go back for a couple of months.
And yeah, every year he would go back, make a big ball, and after this they made another baby after the ball, and so the story goes.
And
on.
So it just went on and on.
Und wenn
and
sie
on
nicht
and
gestorben
on.
Sind und wenn sie nicht gestorben sind, dann leben sie noch heute.
Yes, that's right. So if they haven't
What's
died,
it in English?
If they haven't died yet, they're still living happily to this day.
Yes, that's our version of
Cinderella.
Cinderella, 2019. So the rights are preserved. We don't sell the rights to Walt Disney, by the way. There are better art studios. oh, you never know. Anyway, you don't get the rights, not even for $1 billion would I sell my rights on this one if I had it.
For $1 billion?
So
now, you're just being silly.
No, I've got certain, what is it?
Criteria.
Ich habe meine Prinzipien.
You've
I've got
principles.
My principles. Yes,
You've
some at least. I hope. And they're not for sale. Not to anyone. Really not.
Good.
So.
Well, that brings our podcast to an end today.
Yes, that was lovely.
It was. Ended in a beautiful story.
I had so much fun.
Yeah, it was a great.
I almost wet my pants. I had so much fun.
Clean up all three. No, it was great seeing you again. It was great catching up again. It was much too
yes,
long.
Yes, lovely.
You know, when we promised our fans that we'd catch up after Christmas, they probably didn't think 7 months after Christmas. So we must apologize for this long, very, very long delay in getting the first episode of season two through to you.
And 7 months delay of this big fun.
Cinderella could have had another kid by now.
Such lovely conversation was punishment enough for me, so I don't think of another punishment for myself. Exactly. Apart from inviting you and your two girls, but that's not a punishment, that's a pleasure. Will you come in January? We talk about this offline. I hope you come soon back to Germany, really.
Yes, well, I'd like to come this time. I won't leave my daughter behind. I would like to come with her as well.
That would be awesome.
Yeah.
For a long time, for a month at least.
We'll see what we can do and see when we can do it, because it's not.
Then we make a big ball on Osterberg.
And
here.
We'll send out invitations to all the eligible young men.
Yes.
Yeah,
we invite all the young. Yeah.
Not many will come.
We play this modern version of Cinderella then.
Yeah, so we're really looking. Yeah. that could not work in our favor, you know, unless we'll talk about that offline. We'll make the plans offline.
So I really must go off now.
Okay,
have a lovely evening. Give
you
my
too.
Love to everybody.
I will.
We say hello to our listeners. Thank you that you had so much patience listening to us.
Yeah, thank you for waiting for 7 months for this episode. Thank you.
Exactly. And
we're
if you
glad,
had
we're glad we're back.
If you had just a little bit of fun listening, it would be our greatest
give us
joy
a thumbs
to
up.
Hear.
Subscribe.
Exactly.
Give us a thumbs up.
Bye
and
bye.
We'll listen to you again soon. Oh, we'll talk to you again soon. Bye. Until next one.
Never seen you looking so lovely as you did tonight. never seen you shine so bright. I've never seen so many men ask you if you wanted to dance, looking for a little romance, given half a chance. I have never seen that dress you're wearing, all the highlights in your hair that catch your eye. I have been blind, lady in red, is dancing with me, cheek to cheek. There's nobody here, it's just you and me. Shine so bright, you were amazing. Never seen so many people want to be there by your side. And when you turn to me and smile, it took my breath away. I have never had such a feeling of complete and utter love as I do tonight. Lady.